Howdy folks, Spencer here, and today I'm going to be doing a Leviathan Elite solo. This is a TFO that was put into the game a year or so back, and with the 14th anniversary update, the Elite version of it was added into the game. This doesn't have a timer, but it does have some requirements in the run. You have to make sure to not let any of the Terran dreadnoughts escape, and you have to make sure to rescue all of the allied ships. But time-wise, you can take your time with it. It's a fun TFO to do. It's a nice challenge, but it is a bit lengthy, so it's not going to be for everyone. But the intention of this video is to show that it is possible to do solo. It just takes a bit of time to do. And I do also want to clarify that there's definitely ways to optimize it and do it faster than I am doing it here today. This was the first successful attempt I did, and was just to verify that the TFO could indeed be done solo. So keep that in mind. You know, there's a lot of points in the run where I just am taking things a bit slower than I needed to, just trying to play it safe. And I think on future runs, it could certainly have a bit of time shaved off. And commentary-wise, there isn't a ton throughout most of the video. It's mostly just the raw gameplay. But there is some commentary near the end, and I also have a quick little strategy discussion afterwards, just going over the key things you need to worry about in the run. So as always, chapters to everything are listed down below. And a quick note also, the exact variant of the Delkina build that I used is going to be posted into CasualSAB Discord. So you're going to have to grab the STO role in order to see the Spencer Builds channel to see it. But if you want to take a look at it, it's going to be posted up over there alongside the release of this video. With that out of the way, enjoy the run.
You are approaching the Internatals. Destroy them all. There is a Terran dreadnought escaping in the center lane.
Warning, ship is under attack.
Successfully. fighting!
We have a pair of troublesome dreadnoughts to kill.
Warning! Ship is under attack! Four
Ship is under attack. Target shield has failed.
Ship is under attack. Ship is under attack.
Of the plasma accelerators in the left lane have been disabled.
Warning. Ship is under attack. Ship is
plasma accelerators in the left lane have been disabled.
Ship is under attack.
All of the Citadel plasma accelerators have been disabled. Percent of the right lane plasma accelerators remain functional. Disable the rest. Accelerators in the right lane have been disabled. Enemy dreadnought on escape vector in the left lane. All plasma accelerators are down. Well done. One of your allies has escaped successfully. Successfully. Alliance vessel has successfully escaped. The spiked orbs ahead are shield generators. Disable their shielding and destroy them. One of your allies has escaped successfully.
Target's shield has failed.
One of your allies has escaped success. The left lane shield generators have been eliminated. Generators in the center lane have been destroyed. Remaining in the right lane. The shield generators are destroyed. Proceed to the compilers ahead.
go in and try to get these guys all grouped up together. Just try to get as many of them out in one go as I can. I don't know if my graviton's gonna actually be able to drag them together, but I wanna at least try. Okay. 10 seconds for EP to W, and then I'm gonna go in and start hitting them. Start buffing up, getting closer, gonna get my pets out.
Below 50%. So close to it being flawless. So close.
Warning, ship is under attack. Warning, ship is under attack.
Wouldn't have been for that death at the end, that would have been flawless. All the objectives there. Damn. Definitely some room for improvement. I took a bit more time playing it safe at various points of the run, but I mean, damn, look at that. 586 marks. It took 42 minutes on my own, but I think with some optimizations, it could certainly be done a bit faster. And for the very few of you that are still watching at this point in the video, if you're looking for some tips strategy-wise here, the main priority for you at each of the phases in this run is to take out the Terran Dreadnought. It will tell you what lane it spawns in, and you need to prioritize that lane first in the first three phases of this TFO. And you also need to make sure that you're going in and rescuing the allied ships as soon as possible. In fact, I would go for the allied ships before I would go for the Terran Dreadnought there. So after I did the very first group at the start of the TFO, I went in and I focused on just clearing out the ships around the allied vessels. And you specifically only need to take the one out that has that effect going on, the purple beam there to that allied vessel. Once you've done that, it can actually escape. But you do want to make sure to go in and clear out the rest of the enemies later on if you want to get all the marks. So if you're trying to just get through them as quick as possible, like you'll see me do later in the TFO, or like you saw me do, you know, just prioritize taking out the one that is directly attacking the allied vessel, and then you can clear the rest out later. So again, allied vessels, then take out the Terran Dreadnought at each phase, and then just slowly go through and do all of the objectives that you see at each stage of the run. Now, at the end, you saw that I messed up when engaging the final group here. The Tachyon Net Drones was a good call for me to slot onto the build at this point, but the Graviton, I don't think that actually did that much for me. Let's take a look here again. So Graviton's like a really powerful Gravwell type console. Yeah, it looks, I mean, it caught some of the Guardians, you can see it there, so I mean, it helped a little bit, but I think I would have been better off with just another Isomag on, honestly, just for that extra damage there. For this final phase here, I think just keeping the speed up, once you've got one of them knocked out, you're going to be taking a while to engage the others there, so yeah, just be careful, and especially when these compilers turn into the plasma bolts there. As you saw, that's how I ended up dying in this TFO. Just got to be careful and keep your distance while they're in that mode. Try to keep your evasive and a deuterium saved for when they're in that, and just fly away from them. Let's see, where was my death here? Just, it felt like the death was like almost out of nowhere to me. Yeah, as soon as it's in that mode, if any of those get close enough to you, apparently enough to kill you, like that was two kilometers away from me and it was able to kill me. So definitely do your best to keep some distance from these plasma bolts, because even from that far, like 2 kilometer distance, they can still deal quite a bit of damage to you. Overall, it really isn't that difficult of a TFO. It's more of just the speed to go around, rescue the allies at each stage, make sure you're getting the Dreadnought before it can escape, and then at the final area there, just make sure you keep your speed up, avoid those plasma bolts there. But really not the most challenging TFO to do solo. Rather, the challenge is more in the time that it takes, because 42 minutes is quite a bit of time. So hopefully you enjoyed. It was a fun little challenge to do. It wasn't completely solo flawless like I would have liked. That death there unfortunately ruined that for me, but I might give it another go at some point, but not tonight, not when it's 40 minutes to do. So hope you enjoyed. Let me know if you give this a try, and let me know if you have a faster time. I definitely think that there's room for improvement here, and I think some of you are going to find some creative ways to go in and deal with some of the challenges here, especially at that final boss phase, a bit better than I did. So that's going to be it for today. As always, thank you to all channel members and viewers for the continued support. See you guys around.